this is the short circuit power dissipation expression we have derived, right? Then coming back to these two figures, if you observe that whenever the time constant is going to be increased, the graph is going to be shifted. Is it clear? Then similarly, whenever the load capacitance is zero and the load capacitance is going to be increased, the height of the graph is going to be slightly varying. Is it clear? This is the two figures we have to draw. That means short circuit current as a function of input rise or fall time, variation of short circuit current with load capacitance. Clear? Then coming back to the one more power dissipation. Okay, that is switching power dissipation. This switching power dissipation occurs whenever there is a change from low to high level and a high to low level, the load capacitor charges and discharges, causing power dissipation. That means whenever the capacitor charges and discharges, it leads to a power dissipation. This is known as switching power dissipation. Clear? Then, if you observe these two models, observe this model and this model and this model. Clear? If you observe these two models, that means this is the, I have considered a CMOS inverter as a figure. Let us assume that whenever the input voltage, the gate to source voltage is given as a 0 volts, then this transistor is going to be turned off, that means cutoff region, then it becomes as a current source, then the capacitor, load capacitor is going to be charged from 0 to VDD. Then similarly it is for the exactly opposite operation, right? Then coming back to the derivation, during the transition of the output from 0 to VDD, that means during the load capacitance varies from 0 to VDD, then I am going to express that the energy that is from 0 to VDD, integral 0 to VDD, then I will talk about the power in terms of voltage and current, then this current is going to be in terms of load capacitance, which is equal to I is equal to C into dV by dt. If you observe this expression, I is equal to C into dV by dt. If you talk about the voltage, 1 by C integral I into dt, it is well known to you. From this I have picked up this expression. After substituting this value in this expression, then I can able to write like this. Then the CL is going to be taken as a common side, that means I have taken the VDD and I have taken the CL as an outside. Then if you talk about integral 0 to VDD, then in integral 0 to VDD, 1 into dV, it becomes okay V0, then after substituting VDD minus 0, it becomes VDD, CL into VDD becomes CL VDD square. Is it CL? Is it clear? Then regardless of the waveform we have taken, then I can able to simply say that CL into VDD square is the energy drawn from the power supply from 0 to VDD transition at the load capacitance. Then part of the energy drawn from the supply is stored in the load capacitance. Is it clear? Then this sum of the part, I can able to tell 0 to VDD CL into, then this is my sum of the part of the output voltage. Then I can able to simply say that CL into V0 into dV0. If I take CL as an outside, then integral x into dx become x square by 2, then it becomes upper limit minus lower limit. This is the expression. I can able to say that this implies that half of the energy is stored in the capacitor and the remaining half is dissipated in the PMOS network. Similarly, if you observe the square wave of the repetition frequency of, that means if you supply the square wave with the repetition time interval like this, then you can get that CL VDD square 1 by T, then 1 by T can be written as F. This is the expression. That means CL VDD square into 1 by T can be written as F. This is the power dissipation. Is it clear? All of you. Okay, then if you talk about the some internal concept present in the switch, that means switching power dissipation, then this is the dynamic power for a complex gate. That means just we have seen that the dynamic power, that means for a complex gate, let us consider I have applied a 0 to 1 transition, then you can able to get the 0 to 1 transition if you use a buffer, but you won't get the full swing. If the voltage level is going to be reduced, that means if you reduce the voltage level, that means VDD as a VDD minus VT, then there is a reduced in the voltage swing. That means before you know that this is the expression you have got to you, then this expression is split like this. Then if you don't get the full swing voltage, then I can able to write like this. This I am going to call it as a reduced voltage swing. This is the expression for reduced voltage swing. Clear? This is dynamic power for a complex gate. Just I am going to explain that what happens if I apply the dynamic variation, what happens if there is no full swing voltage. Clear? Then if you talk about the reduced voltage swing, this is the expression. This is one and two, the subtopics. And internal load power. Let us consider this is the circuit. That means this is a NAND gate, 3 input NAND gate I have considered. If I consider the internal load capacitance also, I have to talk about internal load power dissipation also. This is the expression for internal load power dissipation. I have to damn surely consider the internal load capacitance, internal load voltage and the VDD apply. Okay, then switching activity. As we know that the switching activity varies continuously, this is the expression we have got. En, that is here, n is nothing but a switching, that means output transitions. This is the expression we have got then with respect to the switching activities. Clear? Then coming back to the glitching power dissipation, if you talk about the glitching power dissipation, okay, as we said in the starting only, glitch will appear because of the finite gate delay present in the logic gates. Let us consider this is one circuit I have considered. This is the example I have considered for ABC 101. Okay, from 101 to 00 transition, let us assume that from 101 the output is 0, here the output is 0. Okay, for 0 to 0 to 0 the output should be 1 for that. But if you observe that if there is any delay, if there is any finite delay present in the change in the value, then you are getting a some delay in the O2. That means if there is any delay in this, then you are getting some glitch present in that. Okay, if you observe that this power calculation so far, that means whatever the power calculation we have discussed so far, we have assumed that the gates have zero delay, but practically the gates will have a finite delay. If you observe that, then delay will lead to the undesirable transitions at the output, that means unwanted, these unwanted signals, spurious signals means unwanted, known as glitches. In the case of static CMOS circuit, the output node or internal nodes can make undesirable transitions before attaining a stable value. Okay, this is the example we have explained here. Then if you observe that when ABC changes values from 101 to 00, ideally for 0 gate delay, the output should remain at the 0 logic level. However, considering the unit gate delay of the first gate stage, output O1 is delayed compared to the C input. As a consequence, the output switches to 1 logic level for 1 gate delay duration. This transition increases the dynamic power dissipation. This is the glitching power, right? This is the another examples of glitching power. Then last one is a leakage power dissipation. If you talk about the leakage power dissipation, I'm not going to discuss in detail. Okay, I'm going to just discuss briefly. Then here we have a PN junction reverse bias current. That means leakage means there is a leakage. Since PN junction, if you apply the PN junction in the reverse bias, then what happens means because of the minority carriers, there is a leakage current. Okay, this is the expression for the leakage current. Then this is the PN junction reverse bias current. This is the leakage current expression, right? Then if you talk about the tunneling mechanism of the diode, that means due to the tunneling, okay, tunneling mechanism, we are going to see some leakage, band to band tunneling current. Tunnel diode have a tunneling mechanism, that means, okay, it is because of the tunneling effect we have a electric field like this. Clear? This is one more mechanism, band to band tunneling current. This is a tunneling expression. Then subthreshold leakage current. Subthreshold leakage current in CMOS circuit is due to the carrier diffusion between the source and the drain regions of the transistor. Okay, carrier diffusion. Because of the carrier diffusion present in the source and drain, we have a subthreshold effect. Are you clear? Subthreshold leakage current. Okay, then there is a different mechanisms which leads to subthreshold leakage current. These are the drain induced barrier lowering, body effect, narrow width effect, effect of channel length and threshold voltage roll off, effect of temperature. Drain induced barrier lowering occurs because of what means? Because of the depletion region. That means if you observe here, clear, the DABL occurs when the depletion regions of the drain and the source interact with each other near the channel surface to lower the source potential barrier. Because of this, if you observe this, okay, then what you are going to say that because of the source and drain lowering the, see here, if the depletion region of the drain and the source interact with each other near the channel surface, then it lowers the source potential. This is one of the effect of drain induced barrier lowering. Then if you talk about the body effect, it is very important, guys, body effect, because whenever there is a voltage applied to the body, then what happens means there is an increase in the threshold voltage which leads to the change in the modulation, that means change in the length of the modulation. This effect is known as body effect. This is a change in the threshold voltage. Are you clear? This is a change in the threshold voltage. Then one more internal topic present in the leakage power dissipation is narrow width effect. That means whenever the width of the gate reduces, becomes narrow, it affects the threshold voltage. Once again, if you observe that all mechanisms affect the threshold voltage, then it becomes the change in the length of the modulation, then it leads to the, okay, some of the effect depending upon the heading. If you talk about narrow width effect, because of the width present in the gate, it affects the what we'll call threshold voltage body effect because of the applying supply voltage to the body it affect the threshold voltage. Here there is a roll off present in the threshold voltage. As the channel length is reduced, the threshold voltage of metal oxide semiconductor decreases. Are you clear? Then if you talk about temperature effect, we all know that because of the threshold voltage dependency on temperature, VT going to be depends on the temperature, there is effect. Okay, thank you very much. If you see that, we have discussed so far short circuit power dissipation and switching power dissipation, glitching power dissipation and leakage power dissipation. I hope that the first part is completed successfully. Just go through that. Okay, thank you very much.